back to Auto Repair, guys. In today's video, guys, it will be a very helpful video to some of you guys that have Dodge, Jeep or Chrysler, especially guys if you have the 3.6 VVT Pentastar engine. So what we'll be showing you guys, how to fix two codes and the car having a hard time starting, or if you have any of those two codes, guys. We're talking about code P0340 and P0365. Stay with us, guys. In the meantime, we have more than 200 videos on this car, so please subscribe to the channel. Our mission is to save you as much money as we can. So, let's go ahead. I'll go on the inside and show you. The car has a really hard time starting. Okay, and engine light is on. So, let me show you now. Okay, you can see it started, but it started really bad. Engine light is on, so definitely, guys, a problem. We'll turn it off. We'll turn the ignition, click usually twice on the button, no brake, engine not running, and we're going to run our diagnostic tool here. Okay, let me grab it quick, I'm going to show you. Okay, what we are using now? Okay, let's start from the beginning so you know what is happening. Now that tool, guys, you can use it not just on Dodge, you can use it almost on any vehicle you can think of, not just Dodge, Jeep or Chrysler vehicles. So you can see, check it out, it's listed in the description of the video below. We'll click Auto Detect. Next, we're going to select Dodge. After that, guys, okay, we're going to select... it's going to read the VIN number. We need to confirm OK. Select OK. And then we need to confirm that we have the correct vehicle displayed on the screen. Yes, so from that point on, it's pretty simple. We need to click Diagnostics. Next, control unit, so we can select the engine computer under powertrain, engine control module, that's the engine computer, and now we're going to click OK, read codes. And the codes that we got, guys, okay, ignore the last one, this is because our battery is a little bit low. 340 and 365. Camshaft position sensor, bank 1, sensor 1, sensor 2. So let us explain you guys why you have these codes, where it's located, where bank 1 is and how to get to it. So thank you for watching, guys, and let's continue with the job now. So we'll remove with an 8mm the intake holes here. Now let me explain why we'll be doing that, because bank 2 is on the front. Bank 1, this is your rear cylinder head. If you have a rear wheel drive car, your engine will be twisted this way, so bank 1 will be on the left side, but now it's in the rear. We'll remove the intake hose, guys. Okay, so let me go ahead and put this one down. Okay, so we don't break it. Usually that's what it looks like. Now, bank 2 camshaft position sensor, guys. It's located. Okay, let me show you now. Bank 2 is right here. That's bank 2 camshaft position sensor. Bank 1. Okay, it's that guy back there. That's the camshaft position sensor. Why it says sensor 1 and 2? Because that sensor, it has two sensors built in it. Because it has one on the left side, one on the right side when you remove it. Check out the video. We have a video how to replace that. And in the video you can see why it has two sensors, how it's built and all that stuff. So we will not waste your time now, because you have to take so many things apart, okay, to actually remove those sensors. And we'll go ahead, okay, you can find the in the description of the video below, guys, more videos and the playlist for that car, so you can see where we got ours from as well. Check it out, we'll replace ours and we'll continue. So we replaced our sensor, we're going to go on the inside now. Now, do not start the car, no brake. Just run with the engine without running and ignition on. We're going to go back. Okay, and click erase codes. Yes, yes. Codes have been successfully erased. So let's see, let's see if it starts now. It fired, guys, with no problem at all. You can see, pretty simple. So that definitely took care of it. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos and see you guys next time.